Good morning. Greetings and welcome to The Bright Side, your nutritional program dedicated to the understanding of the vast world of nutrition and nutritional supplementation. I'm your host, Pharmacist Ben, nutritional pharmacist from Boulder, Colorado. I use nutritional supplements where other healthcare practitioners use toxic pharmaceutical drugs and sometimes deadly medical procedures. If you suspect that there are natural nutritional roads to your health and vitality and well-being and to addressing your health challenges, whatever they may be, but you don't know where to begin, you have come to the right place. As you listen to The Bright Side every day, you are more and more in control of your body. You are more and more knowledgeable, and you know you can overcome any health challenge. That's why we're here every day on The Bright Side, helping clear up the sometimes confusing world of nutrition and nutritional supplementation. Over the last 29 years of practicing pharmacy, I have seen drug-free recoveries from diabetes, hypertension, obesity, skin diseases like psoriasis, eczema, rosacea, acne, digestive ailments, autoimmune issues of all kinds. Recoveries that, by the standards of modern medicine, can only be called a miracle, but what is in the world of the body, what is in the world of biology, standard operating procedure, because the human body is a healing system. It's a regenerating system. It is designed divinely to heal and renew itself on a moment-to-moment basis. And while some folks may call that healing, renewing, regenerating system a miracle, it's no miracle at all. It is just the way the body works. If you have questions about health or nutrition or prescription drugs, a health challenge you or a loved one may be dealing with, if you want help with the longevity products, you have questions about formulations or ingredients, we want to hear from you. 844-236-6010 is our number on The Bright Side, 844-236-6010. If you or a loved one is dealing with something that seems intractable, please understand, because it is in the nature's body to heal, because it has been evidenced by thousands upon thousands upon thousands of so-called spontaneous remissions from autoimmune diseases, from cancer, from stage 4 cancer, because it is the nature of the body, no one has to be condemned. 844-236-6010 is our number. If you want to purchase any of the longevity products you hear advertised on the program, you can head over to brightsideben.com or criticalhealthnews.com or pharmacistben.com. Purchase products right off the website. You can also sign up to join the Bright Side Ben team right off the websites or call the phone team at 866-735-2470. 866-735-2470. You can also check out my Truth Treatment products if you're interested in checking out some super mega, mega high-end skin health products. No preservative, no fragrance, no wax, no oil, 100% active and functional ingredients, including retinol and vitamin C. And the good stuff, lipophilic vitamin C, fat-soluble, stabilized vitamin C. Head over to truthtreatments.com, truthtreatments.com. If you're dealing with wrinkles or accelerated aging of the skin, or if you have eczema or acne, you're going to want to check out our Truth Retinol Gel and our Truth Serum and Omega-6 Healing Cream and Truth Balm. They're all up at truthtreatments.com. Okay, so we are talking about the ketogenic diet and supplements and dietary strategies, supplemental and food strategies that you want to use if you are going to be exploiting or leveraging the power of fat. Love saying that, the power of fat. This is something Dr. Wallach has been talking about for decades. I've been talking about for decades. It never made sense to me, the whole idea of the low-fat diet. Fat is such an important source of energy, as well as, it turns out, of nutrition. To go low fat is, fortunately, people, even doctors, aren't telling people to go low fat these days. They're saying low good fat or low wrong fat and the right kind of fat, which is what they should have been saying for decades. Anyway, that's what ketogenesis is about. Ketones are produced when the body burns fat. The body burns fat for energy. It produces these things called ketones. Ketones are super mega high energy. Mega high energy, especially important for the brain and for the heart. The heart is a fat burner. Heart is primarily, it prefers fats. That's because of the production of these ketones, at least partially because of the production of these ketones. The brain also loves ketones. It's been, the ketogenic diet is used for epilepsy, but that doesn't, you don't have to have full-blown seizure disorders to benefit. All brain health issues, even as an antidepressant. Improving mood. One of the byproducts of the ketogenic diet is a mood improver called butyric acid. So you don't have to have full-blown epilepsy to benefit from a high-fat ketogenic diet. You don't have to have heart disease. The ketogenic diet is very satisfying. It's great for losing weight. Imagine that. One simple non-medical, non-drug strategy that won't even cost you very much will improve heart health, brain function, improve your mood, and at the same time cause you to lose weight. How do you like that? No Nutrisystem required. No Weight Watchers. No fancy programs required. Just eat fat. The ketogenic diet's 90% fat, technically speaking. That's what the medical ketogenic diet is used for. And yes, the ketogenic diet is medical. It's used in medical settings. It's used to treat seizure disorders. That's its primary medical use, is to treat seizure disorders. Folks, I get letters all the time, Facebook posts from people whose kids have seizure disorders, whose parents have seizure disorders, who they themselves have seizure disorders, and the drugs they give you for these seizure disorders, which, by the way, came out as soon as the ketogenic diet was dismissed in the 1920s, 1930s, one of the first drugs of the modern era, if you will, of pharmaceuticals, was anti-seizure medicines. As soon as that came out, Dilantin, some of you may have heard of it. I think it came out in the late 1920s, early 1930s. All of a sudden, nobody had talked about the ketogenic diet anymore. Well, it turns out Dilantin, Tegretol, Valproic Acid, Depakote, some of you guys may have heard of these terms, these names. These are some of the most deadly toxic of all medication, these anti-seizure medication, because they're basically shutting down your brain. And that takes some intense chemistry. But the ketogenic diet, the 90% fat diet, works just as well. And that's its primary use. Now, you don't have to have seizure disorders, though. You don't have to have a brain problem to take advantage of the power of ketones. I like a modified ketogenic diet, I call it, 60 to 70% fat. Use butter, use coconut oil. The coconut oil in particular is ketogenic diet manna. That's the main source, one of the main sources, probably the main source of fats for the ketogenic diet. But avocados, eggs, fish, green leafy vegetables, which don't appear to be fat, but they do have fat in them. These are all your ketogenic diet foods. They're relatively benign, with the exception of eggs, perhaps. Some people can react to eggs, but most people aren't going to have a problem with fish or avocados. And coconut oil, is, except for its medicinal value, is pretty much inert. And then, so 60 to 70% fat, I call this the modified ketogenic diet, 20% protein, 10 to 20% carbs. And you don't have to go full-blown ketogenic. You can go modified ketogenic, and you will get dramatic benefits. And I am talking dramatic benefits, especially when it comes to weight loss. I read a letter yesterday that I got from a guy whose wife's blood pressure dropped 40 points in a week. In 1 week, 40 points by going ketogenic. For diabetics, go ketogenic. For anybody dealing with heart, brain health issues, or weightlifters, or bodybuilders, or anybody who just wants to perform better. This is from the Navy. Research combats oxygen toxicity in Navy divers. You know what they're doing? They're giving people ketones. And you can eat ketones straight, by the way. There's ketone supplements you can get. We'll talk about that here later on. A couple days, probably, we'll get to ketone supplements. Let's see here. Athletes experimenting with ketogenic diets consistently report greater strength and endurance, cognitive ability, and better recovery and maintenance of lean muscle mass. This is so amazing to me, you guys. I'm going to read it again. This is so amazing. Athletes experimenting with ketogenic diet consistently report greater strength and endurance, cognitive ability, and better recovery and maintenance of lean muscle mass. Why is not everybody doing this? You don't have to be an athlete. We're all athletes. You know, just getting our butt out of bed in the morning is an athletic event. Just going through our day. You don't have to, if an athlete is doing something, we want to pay attention to that. Here's another one for you. This is from the University of Alabama, Birmingham School of Nursing. The impact of ketogenic diet on cognition in older adults with HIV. This is a pilot study, apparently. Actually, they're hoping to help individuals function more independently without adding more medication. That's the beauty of this ketogenic diet, is it supports medication. Here's another one. This one is from the Hyperbaric Biomedical Research Laboratory at the University of South Florida. Researchers develop ketone supplements to enhance cancer therapy. Yes, they're actually trying to come up with ketone medicine, ketone supplements anyway. All right, I'm Pharmacist Ben, 844-236-6010 is our number. You're listening to The Bright Side. We'll be back right after this. We are back on The Bright Side. I'm Pharmacist Ben, got lines open for you at at 844-236-6010. If you have questions about health or nutrition, prescription drugs, the longevity products, formulation, skin health, something you may have heard about, read about, or if you just want to contribute to the conversation, you have a success story, 844-236-6010 is our number on the Bright Side. If you want to purchase any of our Truth Skin Health products, please go to truthtreatments.com and take a specially long look at our retinol 5% gel made with retinol 5% as well as vitamin C and our transdermal delivery matrix. And that's pretty much it. There's a touch of something called fullerenes in there that help improve penetration of the active material. And that's it. No fillers, no wax, no water, no oil, no preservative, no nothing your skin doesn't need or doesn't want. And that's how our Truth Treatment products are all formulated, all four of our products. And you can check them out at truthtreatments.com, truthtreatments.com. If you want to purchase any of the longevity products, head over to brightsideben.com, criticalhealthnews.com, or pharmacistben.com, or you can call the phone team at 866-735-2470 for a one-time $25 fee. You can start yourself a longevity business and help spread the word about the power and importance of a good nutritional supplement program. Of course, you can also just get your products at the wholesale price if that's all you want to do. For a one-time $25 fee, please call the phone team, 866-735-2470, or head over to brightsideben.com, criticalhealthnews.com, or pharmacistben.com. Okay, so I don't want to beat a dead horse here. Suffice it to say, the ketogenic diet is it's a good idea for most of us. High fat, moderate protein, low carbohydrate. The low carb is really, that's the most, well, they're all important. Okay, if you're going to go ketogenic, if you decide, oh, well, this sounds really good and it's not a bad idea to do it. And by the way, the ketogenic diet was designed as a way of mimicking fasting, of mimicking the biochemistry of fasting. So if you can't do a fast, but you want to leverage the chemistry, the biochemistry that's associated with fasting, or you don't feel like fasting forever, and you want to leverage the biochemistry, the ketogenic diet will allow you to do that. High fat, low carb, moderate protein. But if you're going to go ketogenic, you want to, there's supplements you're going to want to use. There's nutritional and dietary strategies you're going to want to use to leverage the ketogenic diet. We talked about lecithin. We spent a couple of days talking about lecithin, which helps the body process fats as part of bile. It has its own nutritional benefits. It has its own health benefit profile, if you will, especially for the brain and the digestive system and the nervous system in general and the heart. We spent a lot of time on that. And there's also vitamin E, which we started talking about yesterday. Vitamin E is a calming vitamin. Fats are designed to burn. They oxidize. That's what oxidation is. Oxidizing is burning, and that's what fats do. And we all know that. That's how we run our cars, is we burn fat. Fats designed to burn. They oxidize. But that oxidation, that burning, has to happen carefully. A fire can burn down your house, or it can run your car, run your machinery. The difference is control. In your car, that fire is controlled. In a house, it's not controlled. So fire is very important stuff, but somehow the body has to control it. In fact, that's really what all of nutrition is all about, controlled fire. That's what life is all about. That's what the life force is. It's controlled fire. And that's where vitamins and the mighty 90 essential nutrients come in. They control the fire. That's how they work. The fire will burn down your body, but if it's controlled, that fire can run your muscles and your heart and your brain. That, my friends, is nutrition in a nutshell. And it's poor health in a nutshell. When we don't have the mighty 90 essential nutrients, we burn. Our bodies burn up. That's how we die. Our bodies burn up. But when we have the mighty 90 essential nutrients, and I'm often asked, what exactly is a vitamin? What is the mighty 90 essential nutrient? What are they? They control the fire. That's basically what they do. And vitamin E is the classic, the quintessential fire-controlling nutrient. It controls the fire of fats. Fats are designed to oxidize, to burn. And the more fats we ingest, the more fire we got, the more burning we have. It's like drinking more. It's like your car getting more oil or putting gasoline on a fire. The more fats we eat, the more fats we ingest, the more nutrition we need. One of the hugest problems with the way we subsist, our standard American diet, is too much of the wrong kinds of fat without enough of these fat-stabilizing nutrients, these fire-control nutrients. So you end up with fires, burning. That's the problem with fats right there, you guys, right there. Now, if you're going to start to take advantage of fats, which I recommend, then you need these fire control nutrients. And vitamin E is the quintessential fire control nutrient. That's its major, major role. It's the ultimate fat fire quenching nutrient, vitamin E. It allows oxidation to occur in a careful, strategic, productive fashion rather than burning down your body. Vitamin E is calming. It's stabilizing. It helps prevent inflammation. It helps prevent excessive excitation. It helps prevent excitotoxicity. It has protective effects against stress hormone, against cortisol. It's one of the neat benefits of vitamin E. So, by the way, not only do you need more vitamin E, the more fats you're using, the more fats you're intaking, but the more stress you're under. You need more, the more vitamin E, and that's doesn't not just psychological stress, although that too. Also physiologic stress. The more physiologic stress you're under, the more vitamin E you need. From the Department of Pharmacology at Shah Alam University in Malaysia, this was published in the Archives of Medical Science, supplementation with vitamin E, palm vitamin E, or alpha tocopherol, reduces the formation of gastric lesions, stomach ulcers basically, probably by inhibiting the elevation of corticosterone levels induced by stress. So vitamin E is an anti-stress vitamin. It helps prevent the toxicity associated with cortisol. And by the way, estrogen, we'll talk about that here later on. Estrogen is a stress hormone in many of its guises, and vitamin E is one of the best ways to protect yourself from toxic estrogen. You know, most of the people who have autoimmune diseases are women. That's because autoimmunity and toxic estrogen go hand in hand. You guys, you've got MS, you got sarcoidosis, you got whatever, type 1 diabetes or rheumatoid arthritis or you name it, whatever autoimmune disease you got, you might want to think about using vitamin E, 400 international units a day. Not that everybody wouldn't benefit, but especially if you're dealing with some kind of inflammatory immune stress condition. And all of this makes vitamin E the perfect associate, the perfect nutritional colleague for the ketogenic diet, which is also a calming and stabilizing diet. And many of the same benefits that we attribute to the ketogenic diet, you can attribute to vitamin E. Vitamin E is anti-seizure. Vitamin E is important for the heart. Vitamin E is important for mood. Vitamin E is important for the brain. Just like the ketogenic diet is important for all of these, for helping the body accomplish all of these ends, vitamin E is very similar. It's a calming and stabilizing vitamin, just like the ketogenic diet is a calming and stabilizing diet. And vitamin E is anti-seizure. From the journal Alternative Medicine Review, we learned that vitamin E, in addition to other nutrients like taurine, also anti-seizure, magnesium, vitamin B6, these are also anti-seizure. We learned that vitamin E, in addition to these other nutrients, may reduce seizure frequency. And even according to this article, which was published in March of 2007, vitamin E may allow for dosage reduction or even complete discontinuation of anti-seizure medication. And given the fact, as we talked about moments ago, that these are really, really toxic drugs, the anti-seizure medicines are among the most toxic, along with the beta blockers and the calcium channel blockers and digoxin. These are among the most toxic and deadly drugs in the entire pharmacopoeia. The anti-seizure medicine, and we know now, at least according to this article, that vitamin E supplementation may allow you to reduce your dose of these nasty medications. All right, I'm Pharmacist Ben. You are listening to The Bright Side. We're coming back with your phone calls. 844-236-6010 is our number. We'll be back right after this. We are back on The Bright Side. Thank you for joining us. We're on the air Monday through Friday, 8 to 9 Pacific and 10 to 11 Central Time, 24-7 on our archive pages, benfuchsarchives.com. And brightsideben.com. You can also check out my blog at criticalhealthnews.com. We also have videos up there. And then pharmacistben.com. Thank you to Robert Lundgren and John T. Collier for setting those up. And you can purchase longevity products right off the website as well. criticalhealthnews.com, pharmacistben.com, or brightsideben.com. And of course, if you want to join the Brightside Ben team, you can do it right off the website. Websites, or you can call 866-735-2470. Got lines open for you. Hang tight if you're on hold. 844-236-6010 is our number. If you're dealing with a health challenge, if you want help with it, please understand there are no intractable, irreversible health challenges, period. Except for death, and maybe not even death, as near-death experiences tell us. Do you know there's like something like 13 million near-death experience accounts now? I remember the first time I read about near-death experiences, I was 16 years old. I read a book called Life After Life by a guy named Ray Moody. And I'm telling you, man, and I've had one, by the way, these near-death experiences, they don't tell you that there's something else out there or there's thing, the world is bigger the world is bigger than we believe or than we've been taught. Nothing like a near-death experience to wake people up. And that's what happens, by the way, when people have these near-death experiences. They all come back, most of them come back not afraid of death. The vast majority of them come back not afraid of death. I was listening to this video about the scout. I forgot her name. She wrote a book called Dying to Be Me. And she has a video out. Anita Moorjani is her name. M-O-O-R-J-A-N-I. She says she learned five things from her near-death experience. Number one, she said she learned about love. And loving everybody, yes, but especially about loving herself. That is so powerful, you guys. Behind so much of our crisis, our personal and existential crises, is a lack of self-love. I would say behind all of it, but at least behind so much of it. So she says, number one, loving everybody, but especially loving herself. Number two, she says she learned to live fearlessly. There's nothing to fear. We're here to have experiences. And when you have a near-death experience, when you die and come back, you realize that there's nothing to fear. So she says she learned to live fearlessly. How cool is that? So just like behind most of our crises is self-loathing and self-hate and lack of self-love. How much of our crises are on top of fear? How much of fear? What is the impact of fear behind our crises? I'd say it's pretty darn significant. What if we could live fearlessly? What if we wake up in the morning and live fearlessly? You know, when we're kids and we wake up in the morning, we bound out of bed. We jump out of bed. We can't wait to get out of bed. And then all of a sudden something happens somewhere in our 20s or maybe even our teens where we want to put the covers over our head and we don't want to get out of bed. We learn to fear. And it's encouraged. Fear is encouraged. Oh my God, have you watched the news? Fear is encouraged. Donald Trump and politicians and terrorism and dirty bombs and recessions and oh my God, fear's everywhere. What if we could live fearlessly? Well, this gal says she came back from the dead, literally, and learned to live fearlessly. The third thing she says she learned is that life is a gift. Enjoy it. We're here to learn. We're here to have a good time. She says something really cool. She says, if you're in the middle of a challenge, you just haven't gotten to the end of it. That's so true. Whenever we're in a challenge and it's over after a year or 2 years or 3 years, we look back and we see what a lesson it was. So if we're in the middle of a challenge and it seems like life is not a gift, we're just not at the end of the challenge. That's all it is. Fourth thing she said she learned is to play, to laugh, humor, to have fun. And the fifth thing, let me think here. Now, the fifth thing escapes me now. I forgot what the fifth thing. Oh, that's the coolest one. Here's the fifth thing. Be yourself. Don't live anybody else's life. Be the best you can be. Shine your light brightly. Don't worry what anybody says. Don't worry if they're laughing. Don't worry if they're criticizing. Be yourself. Be the best self you can be. We're all unique individuals like snowflakes. Be the best snowflake you can be. Whatever your particular flavor is. We all have our own unique personalities. Be that to the max. 100%. Who cares what anybody says? That's what we're here for. How cool is that? Five things she learned from her near-death experience. Love, live fearlessly, life is a gift, play, humor, have fun, and be yourself. All right. And that's, you know what? That's just as cool as nutrition to me. Because that's what this is really about. Nutrition is great. I love biochemistry and I love nutrition. But the mind, the power of the mind over the body, the power of the mind to heal is so amazing. All of these strategies that we talk about on the bright side, nutritional and non-nutritional strategies, are about exploiting or leveraging our amazingness. All right, 844-236-6010 is our number. Diane in Nebraska. What's up, Diane? How you doing? Good morning.
Ben, my husband is suffering with nerve compression after the shingles.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, he's still got the facial paralysis and vertigo.
Oh, my God. Okay. Here, let me give you some ideas, okay? First of all, have him go to a massage therapist and do some massage work. His nerves may be in shock. After a trauma like shingles, the nerves may just be in shock. He may need to move them around. Either he can do it himself, but maybe he found somebody who's trained that way. They might know the right muscles and right nerves in the face to work. Okay, that would be the first thing I would do. Next thing you want to do is start to use some mega doses of anti-inflammatory nutrients, particularly vitamin E. If he's not on vitamin E, have him get on it right away. 400, even 800 IU for a couple of days or a week or so, and then back down to 400. okay? Make sure he's doing all his fats, his omega fats, the ultimate EFAs. And then let me think if there's anything else that I would be doing if I were you. If he's doing anything that's causing any inflammation in the body through from food and digestion, he wants to bail on that at least for a couple of days. You know what I'm saying? I mean, shouldn't be interacting with those kinds of foods at all, but at least for a couple of days. Inflammation at this point is not his friend. It's never our friend, but at this point for your husband, it's very serious. Vitamin C high doses as a general tonic, maybe 2,000 milligrams a day, and absolutely get him on the Healthy Start pack as soon as possible. Or if he's not on it already, order it as soon as you can so he gets the basic Mighty 90 essential nutrients. And then to clear out some of that toxicity, have him do 200 or 300 micrograms, actually maybe more, 400 micrograms of selenium a day, 50 milligrams of zinc picolinate a day. And then probably if he wants to do one more thing, alpha lipoic acid, which is kind of a general immune boosting anti-inflammatory nutrient, 400 milligrams a day. Okay, and then also just relaxing the body. As he relaxes his muscles, his skeletal muscles, his facial muscles will relax. I've said this before, we carry a lot of tension in our face all the time, whether we've had shingles or not. So just relaxing the face. If you could learn to relax your face, you guys, and Diane, listen, if you could learn to relax your face, even you do it right now while you're listening to me, you're going to drop your blood pressure. Just relaxing your face. Can you feel how, are you doing it, Diane, there? Relaxing your face, kind of let your mouth hang and let everything sort of hang. That's an amazing, amazing exercise to do just for general activation of the healing relaxation nervous system, parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, good luck with everything, Diane. I hope that helps. Okay, take care. Okay, bye-bye. All right, let's go to Michigan. Good morning, Jim. How you doing, buddy?
Hey, Ben, how you doing?
I'm doing good. What's going on?
Well, I have another subject, but, you know, as far as that last caller, I've done a lot of vaccine research.
Okay.
And years ago when they brought out the chickenpox vaccine,
yeah,
there was a lead scientist that worked for the CDC that noticed that after a few years...
They got shingles.
See, what happened was, it used to be a disease of old people who were...
Hey, Jim, we got a commercial. I want to hear the story, but you got to hold, okay? Can you hang on?
Absolutely.
Okay, thanks, Jim. I'm Pharmacist Ben. You're listening to The Bright Side. We'll be back right after this. Don't go away. Okay, we are back on The Bright Side. 844-236-6010 is our number. Let's go back to Michigan. Jim, what's going on, man?
Yeah, well, like I was saying, Ben, they didn't create the chickenpox vaccine because, you know, bodies were being stacked up in the road like cordwood.
With chickenpox.
It was called, the chickenpox. They created it because it was a vaccine of convenience, I guess you would say, because... You know, the children would get the chickenpox, and mom would have to take a week and a half off work to take care of the child.
So they give you the virus just to make sure that doesn't happen.
Right, but instead of doing it the proper way, I mean, when I was young, I had chickenpox. My kids had chickenpox. But man has really screwed up the balance of how God made antibodies. So what they found is that, let's say, when I was a kid, I had chickenpox. When my children had chickenpox, I was exposed to the disease. My body recognized the disease.
You didn't get the chickenpox.
Right, but I got a few more antibodies because my body was in my body.
Right, but the nature of immunity is such as once you get your chickenpox, you're not going to get it again.
Right, and the reason that the shingles were always kept in check, Ben, is because, you know, my children had chickenpox, and my grandchildren would get chickenpox, and I'd be exposed to it again, so... We were always rebuilding the antibodies, even though didn't get the chicken pox. So
That's
what happened was, this scientist, okay, went back to the CDC, and he was a top CDC scientist, and told them, he said, if you don't stop giving the chicken pox vaccine, you're going to see the shingles. I mean, and they have shingles cases now of children.
But they have a shingles vaccine now, Jim.
Yeah.
That takes care of that, doesn't it?
Until something else shows up because of the vaccine.
Right, I know. It doesn't even work. It doesn't even really work. Do you remember that Cat in the Hat story, little cat A and little cat B and C and He kept. Do you ever read that story? How little cat A took care of the stain, but there was a bigger stain, and little cat B took care of that, but there was something else, and little cat C, and that's how it goes. You can't mess around with, as you say, God's balance like that, and that is the the real issue. It's perfect, right? We should be enjoying
it.
We should be enjoying it. You know, in the Bible, it talks about getting kicked out of the Garden of Eden. It's not so much we get kicked out as like we left. You know, we went out. It's like we're here. We got all we need, right? We're in the Garden of Eden. We got everything we need. We got plenty of abundance, plenty of wealth, plenty of energy. You know, the whole planet is a ball of energy. There's no shortage of anything, but we just went out of it, or we bought the lie that we have to struggle and we have to strife and we have to suffer, and we need the medical model to interfere, to take care of us, to save us, despite the fact that everywhere we turn, we're sicker than ever before with all our drugs and with all our devices and with all our medical protocols. I would be so embarrassed if I was a doctor, if I was a GP or an internal practitioner, any kind of doctor, with the failure rate of medicine. I was embarrassed to be a pharmacist. You know, when I was dispensing drugs. Anyway, Jim, you didn't call to hear me babble. What's going on, man?
Well, I wanted to tell you, too, Ben, that, you know, let people know, I have an 18-year-old son and a 24-year-old daughter. Neither have been vaccinated any time in their life. My 18-year-old son, Ben, has never seen a medical doctor in his life.
Never. He was
born at home. And they're both perfectly healthy. My daughter only saw a medical doctor for a physical for sports. So, and we never took her to a doctor, and she still doesn't go to doctors because, you know, God gave us, and we've always taken Tangy Tangerine.
But that's awesome. God gave us Tangy Tangerine, too, by the way. That's awesome.
Well, back when they were young, it was Cherry Mints, you know, but.
Yeah, that's right. How long have you been doing this a while, then? Have you and I met?
No, but I remember when you used to call into Dr. Wallach's show before you actually started, guest appearing for him.
Yeah,
that's what. 20-some years I've been
doing
this.
That's 20 years,
But I wanted to bring up a point that you brought up. You talked to my brother from Michigan, actually, the other day. And I remember a doctor on the radio about 20-some years ago. And I remember this like it was yesterday because I heard so many times. I'd always tell my customers about it. But he would say, well, we found a cure for rheumatoid arthritis, and that you have to be on small doses of, he called minocycline.
Yes, doxycycline, right.
And what he said, and guess who the doctor was?
Dr. Wallach.
It was Dr. Wallach, absolutely.
Yeah, that's funny.
We all learn, don't we?
You hit the nail on the head there, man. We're always learning. It's all a learning experience. What's going on? Can I help you with anything? I want to get to some calls here. Can I help you with anything specific? I mean, I'm enjoying talking to you, but
no,
I got a bunch.
I'm just going to say that for anybody, I was telling you before, Doc Wallach has a summer and winter place up here about 5 miles from my house. And it's in Petoskey, and there's going to be Dr. Wallach's going to be in town on the 25th of May, and there's going to be a great lecture from 5 till 8 o'clock in case anybody wants to know. So
very cool. Right. You know Shar? You know my friend Shar Murphy?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay. Say hi to Shar for me.
I sure will, Ben. Thanks.
All right. Good to talk to you, buddy. Good to talk to you, Jim. All right. Tracy in California, thank you for being so patient. What's going on? How can I help you? Oh, maybe Tracy wasn't patient here. You there, Tracy?
Oh, no, I'm here. Yes, I'm here.
Hi, Tracy.
Hi, Ben. I have a quick question. I have an autoimmune disease called Sjogren's syndrome.
Yes, ma'am.
And it's been there for 13, 15 years. So I have tried the elimination diet.
Yeah, what'd you notice?
Allergy.
What did you notice?
Yeah, I feel much better. But
very nice.
Right. So
what did you hang on, Tracy? Just a moment, Tracy. What did you eliminate?
Well, at first I go through the detox phase, and then after that I would eliminate all the gluten, corn, dairy.
Got it.
Different things.
What are you eating? What are you eating now? What did you find that you could eat with the Sjogren's that didn't bother you?
Well, right now, my menu have a lot of vegetables. Rainbow color vegetables.
Okay.
And for protein, I'm eating salmon and also organic wild salmon and organic chicken. That's all.
Okay, good. And then let me just ask you a couple questions because we're going to help a lot of people here. So your symptoms, your Sjogren's syndromes, if they were 10 before you started, what number would they be at now? Lower numbers, you know, 0 to 10. If they're 10 when you started, the worst, what are they at now?
At 5.
Awesome.
It reduced substantially. Yeah.
Awesome. That's awesome. With no drugs, just by using dietary strategies. I want everybody to hear that because you know what, Tracy? There's millions upon millions of people who have autoimmune diseases and they're going to specialists and they're taking drugs and nobody is helping them. And that's what this is about. The simple little things. Just by eliminating food, you go from a 10 to a 5. There's way more you can do too, by the way, Tracy. We only have a couple minutes.
I'm taking supplement as well. I'm taking a lot of essential fatty acid.
Very good. Take vitamin E. Don't forget the vitamin E.
No, I didn't take vitamin E, but I take a lot of vitamin C.
Start taking vitamin E. No. Start taking vitamin E. It'll make a big difference. And start taking alpha lipoic acid and selenium. They'll all make a difference. They all work together. And I only have about a minute. Tracy, I only got about a minute.
Go ahead. Ben, what longevity product should I take?
Healthy Start Pack, for sure. Uh-huh. Healthy Start Pack, and sip on the BTT all day long. Make sure you're taking the Ultimate Nightly Essence as well, 3 in the morning, 3 in the afternoon, 3 at night. The Fucoid Z, 3 in the afternoon, 3 in the morning, 3 in the afternoon, 3 at night. And the Ultimate Selenium, probably 400 micrograms a day. And then in addition to that, you're going to want to use vitamin E, 400 IU a day, alpha lipoic acid, 400 milligrams a day. I would take a little bit more vitamin C if I were you, and then 50 milligrams of zinc picolinate a day. And then 20,000 IU of vitamin A a day. And make sure you're getting your vitamin D from the sun in addition to the Ultimate EFAs and also the fish. You're going to get vitamin D there. But make sure you're laying out in the sun a little bit in California, you know, maybe even 10, 15 minutes a day. Don't want to burn, but the sun is incredibly important for improving immunity. And then last but not least, you want to make sure you got a good source of glutathione protein, which is whey protein. This is just whey protein, help you make glutathione, which is the body's major immune booster. And then with your supplement program, get yourself on about a teaspoonful of glutamine powder every day. And you should notice some real significant differences, and we'll get you down from a 5 to a 0 because everything is reversible, Tracy. Every autoimmune disease, every inflammatory disease, these are all processes, diabetes, whatever, Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, these are processes, they're verbs, they're actions, they're things that are happening to us in movement, which means we can reverse it. The medical model wants us to think it's a noun, it's a solid, it's a thing. It's not, folks. Everything is reversible if you do it correctly. All right, I'm Pharmacist Ben. You've been listening to The Bright Side. Thanks so much, Tracy. Appreciate your call. And thanks for sharing that. That's awesome news. We'll be back at you tomorrow talking more ketogenesis and other supplements you could use for the ketogenic diet to leverage and optimize its benefits. Check out my website, truthtreatments.com, also brightsideben.com and pharmacistben.com. Have yourselves an awesome, beautiful, spectacular day. We'll talk to y'all later, folks. Bye for now.